Hello guys, good morning. Welcome to my channel Chemical Diary. Today I came up with an idea to explain you about the production of sulfuric acid, how sulfuric acid is manufactured industrially. So I'm going to explain you by deep contact process, DCDA, double contact double absorption process. Okay guys, so it is easier for understanding. I will explain you the overview and equipment functions. This is molten sulfur pit, clean sulfur, dirty sulfur pit. So we get the sulfur raw material as sulfur from the truck. So we unload it in the dirty pit. If the quality of the sulfur is good, then directly we send it to the molten pit. Here you can see that this is a steam coil. We supply continuous steam to the steam coil so that our sulfur remain in molten state. After that, we have combustion furnace. So in combustion furnace, combustion take place. So sulfur react with oxygen and turns to sulfur dioxide. This is the waste heat boiler in which the furnace temperature is around 1000 degrees. So we have to remove the heat, that much heat from the process gas. So this is the waste heat boiler which remove the heat and generate steam. This is the converter, I can say catalytic converter, in which there are 5 beds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or you can pick 3 bed or 4th bed as per your acid production, as per your requirement. So the beds have V2O5, vanadium pentoxide catalyst. This is the superheated heater which produce superheated steam, and this is the heat exchanger which exchange the heat of the process gas. This is the oleum tower and oleum pump tank. With the help of pump, oleum is pumped to the tower and again it drained back. So continuous circulation take place, and from bottom gas goes and from top gas absorb. So here also from top gas goes to the intermediate absorption tower and acid is sprayed. And this is the economizer which preheats the boiler feed water which is going to the steam drum. And this is the final absorption tower in which sulfuric acid circulated to the from the top, and from bottom gas goes and react and thus become sulfuric acid. And this is the scrubbing tower in which scrubbing solution is used as caustic, and from bottom gas goes and from tops caustic solution is scrub and thus is get neutralizes, and the gas the process gas, so it will be air which goes to the stack. So this is the view overview. Now before explaining this, I hope it's better to explain you in the 3 streams. First one is gas stream, another is acid stream, and another is steam stream, and is sulfur. So I will explain you first sulfur section, then I will explain you the gas section. So let's go to the sulfur route. We get molten sulfur or dry sulfur. So we get molten sulfur, so we send this molten sulfur to the dirty pit. If acidity content or if dirty impurities are not, then as sulfur quality is good, then we can directly send to the molten sulfur. Then what happen, from molten sulfur, sulfur is sprayed to the combustion furnace. You can see that this is the atomizer and orifice plate is there, so it increases the pressure, and high pressure sulfur goes to the combustion furnace and it spread and it vaporizes. And from here we have process air filter. From here air is we get air from the startup boiler or either from steam turbine. So we get the air, but air has moisture, so we send the air to the drying tower. From top sulfuric acid is sprayed, so what happened, whatever the moisture in the air is removed and whatever the pure air, it goes to the combustion furnace. So in combustion furnace, sulfur react with oxygen and becomes sulfur dioxide. Then the furnace temperature will be around 1000 degrees, so we have to remove this heat because we can't send this 1000 degree temperature through the first bed of catalyst. So therefore we remove the heat by sending this gas to the waste heat boiler. Then from waste heat boiler gas to the goes to the first bed, and from first bed the gas temperature will be around 420. So what happen when sulfur dioxide goes passes to the vanadium pentoxide catalyst bed? What will happen? The heat is released, so we have to remove the heat so that we can pass this sulfur process gas to the other bed. So we send this gas to the superheater, then from superheater again gas goes to the second bed, from second bed again heat is released, so we send this gas to the third bed, and from third bed, and then from heat exchanger again from what happened? So we divided the heat is we divided the catalyst into 5 beds so that we can easily remove all the heat and we can easily convert the all the sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide in easy method. So after that, what happened? From third bed gas goes to the heat exchanger, from heat exchanger it comes to the oleum tower. Check from bottom oleum goes, and here this is the oleum pump tank which pumps and circulate the oleum to the oleum tower. From top oleum is sprayed and circulated, from bottom oleum goes, so whatever the sulfuric acid, whatever the sulfur trioxide get absorbed in oleum, then the remaining gas will goes from here and goes to the intermediate absorption tower. So from gas from then here also sulfuric acid is circulated, so from top acid go circulated, from bottom gas again it contact with the sulfuric acid and concentration increases, then again gas goes to the again from here gas goes to the heat exchanger, and from heat exchanger again gas goes to the fourth bed. From fourth bed around 420 or 430 temperature gas goes, so when it pass to the catalyst, then sulfur dioxide convert to sulfur trioxide, then the sulfur trioxide is converted, then what will happen? Again heat is released, so the exothermic heat is removed, so we will again send it to the heat exchanger. From heat exchanger again heat is utilized, then again we send this gas to the fourth bed. Then what happened? After fourth bed the gas goes to the V2O5 fourth bed, vanadium pentoxide gas, then again heat is released, so that heated gas we send to the economizer. Then from economizer what happened? Whatever the boiler feed water, it takes the heat from the gas, and the boiler feed water goes to the steam drum and get preheated, so the gas temperature is removed, so this gas goes to the final absorption tower. From final absorption tower gas goes to the this stack, and from scrubbing section directly goes to the stack, that is atmosphere. So I have covered the gas route, I have covered the sulfur section. Now I will explain you about the acid section. Dear guys, this is a common acid pump tank, and this is a final absorption tower, this is intermediate absorption tower, and this is the drying tower. The drying tower function is to dry the process gas. We circulate sulfuric acid in drying tower, we circulate sulfuric acid in final tower and intermediate absorption tower. So these three have the same function, have the same sulfuric acid. So I will explain you one of the tower. This is the common acid pump tank. Whatever the acid get drained from these three tower and get collected in this pump, again the with the help of circulation pump we circulate the acid by passing to the PHE, because when sulfur trioxide react with sulfuric acid it releases heat, so we have to remove the heat, so that's why we use this plate type heat exchanger. So from here acid gets circulated and goes to the different tower. This is the final absorption tower. From top sulfuric acid is circulated and bottom gas goes, so sulfur trioxide contact with sulfuric acid and its concentration increases. So when concentration of sulfuric acid increases, then what will happen? We will add dilution water, so dilution water is added. Then after adding the dilution water, then what will happen? The concentration reduces. When concentration decreases, we will cut off the water. So continuously what will happen when we add the water? The level increases, so level increases, then whatever the level increase, we'll send this to the product acid storage tank. So this is about the acid section. Continuously same process take place in this final tower, intermediate tower, and let's go to the oleum section. This is a oleum pump tank. From here oleum get drained, and with the help of pump we supply oleum to the packing. So whatever the oleum is that, it absorbs the sulfur trioxide again. So if concentration of sulfuric acid is reduced, then we can send this oleum to the absorption column, to the oleum pump tank. So I have covered the gas section, sulfur section, and acid section. Now I would like to explain you about the steam section. So guys, this is a boiler feed water from battery limit. From outside the battery limit, we get the boiler feed water. Then we send, then we pass this boiler feed water to the economizer. It preheats and it goes to the steam drum. So in a steam drum, the whatever the water, boiler feed water, it goes to the waste heat boiler and continue, and it recovered the heat from the waste gas, and it become here steam, saturated steam. Then from this, the whatever the steam is that, it goes to the superheater. Then from superheater, the steam get heated and becomes superheated. So superheated steam goes to the steam turbine. So from steam turbine, again it goes to the again another turbine, and so the resultant pressure will be, steam pressure will be around 1 kg. So 1 kg pressure we will send it to the condensate, as condensate tank again, that outside battery limit. So that condensate, the battery limit people use for the derater or for the, and utilize as a DM water. So this was the overview of the diagram and production of sulfuric acid, how we manufacture sulfuric acid by double contact, double absorption. So double contact, double absorption, the name given itself shows that double absorption, we double absorption take place. First absorption take place intermediate absorption tower, and the final tower. So it is double absorption, double contact, because after third bed we send to the intermediate tower, oleum tower, again it goes to the, again is go to fourth bed and fifth bed.